I will now call this meeting to order. Madam Clerk, please call the roll.
Commissioner Dyer?
Here.
Commissioner Kane is excused. Commissioner Nash?
Here.
Commissioner Betteridge?
Here.
Commissioner Young?
Here.
Deputy Director McDonald?
Here.
Director Capelli?
Here. This meeting has been properly advertised and posted in accordance with the Open Public Meetings Act. I'll now ask everyone to stand for a moment of silence and the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. Commissioner Betteridge, will you lead us?
Pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank you, everybody. That never works out well. All right, we will start with the commissioner's resolutions. We will begin with Commissioner Dyer.
Thank you, Director. Number one, resolution authorizing agreements pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden, Department of Public Works, and STV Incorporated for a preliminary and final engineering design of Cooper's Point Waterfront Walk Extension in the City of Camden in the amount of $1,008,429.85. Number two, amending an agreement pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden, Department of Public Works, and Consulting Engineer Services for additional closely related engineering design services for roadway improvements to Evesham Road, County Road 544, from Schubert Avenue, County Road 736 to Charles Road, in the boroughs of Runnymede, Magnolia, and the Township of Gloucester in the amount of $70,179.76. Number three was pulled. Number four, resolution authorizing water contract bid B-16/2021 second year option bind between the County of Camden Department of Public Works and Asphalt Paving Systems, Inc. for the provisions of on-call emergency service and repairs for Camden County and the City of Camden under the Camden County Cooperative Pricing System on an as-need basis. Number five, authorizing water contract bid B-26/2022 bind between the County of Camden Department of Public Works and Asphalt Paving Systems, Inc. for snow plowing on various roads in various municipalities in the County of Camden on an as-need basis. Number six, resolution rejecting bid B-24/2022, County Road 758, Coles Mills Road, Barwood Road to Grove Street, located in the township of Haddon and borough of Haddonfield, as the one bid received substantially exceeded the budget for this purpose. Number seven, authorizing a shared service agreement bind between the County of Camden Department of Public Works and the Pollution Control Financing Authority of Camden County for snow plowing and ice control on Camden County roads. Number eight, authorizing a shared service agreement bind between the County of Camden Department of Public Works and the Borough of Audubon for installation and maintenance of solar powered display signs on the East Atlantic Avenue County Road 744 between Chestnut Street and Kings Highway, County Road 551 in the borough of Audubon. Number nine, authorizing a shared service agreement bind between the County of Camden Department of Public Works and the borough of Haddon Heights for roadway improvements on 13th Avenue. Number 10, authorizing a memorandum of agreement bind between the County of Camden Department of Public Works and the City of Camden for temporary construction easements and maintenance of improvements for Canes Avenue, County Road 607, roadway improvements and bridge replacement project in the Township of Pensauk and the City of Camden. Number 11, authorizing a shared service agreement by and between the County of Camden Department of Public Works and the City of Camden for traffic line painting on an as-needed basis. Number 12, ratifying the submission of a grant application by the County of Camden Department of Public Works to the Federal Highway Administration, New Jersey Department of Transportation for the 2023 Local Bridge Future Needs Program in the amount of $1,400,557. 13, resolution authorizing award of contract by and between the County of Camden Department of Public Works and Loftus Construction Inc. for State Street, County Road 601, Historic Bridge 2A-1 repair in the City of Camden in the amount of $30,000. Resolution 14, authorizing the appointment of the county engineer. And number 15 is approving my personnel actions. And I will be reading Commissioner Kane's resolutions, starting with number 16, amending agreement pursuant to the publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden Department of Building and Operations and IEE Group LTD for additional closely related space planning services for the office space in the Woodcrest Corporate Center in the amount of $60,180. 17, authorizing an award of contract bid A-51/2022 by and between the County of Camden Department of Buildings and Operation and Cobby Construction LLC for Camden County Library System and Allen Vogelson Library renovations in the amount of $309,000. 18, rejecting bid A-57/2022 for snow removal and de-icing services for various Camden County departments and Camden County Improvement Authority and Camden County College under the Camden County Cooperative Pricing System, ID-57-CCCPS, and no bids were received. 19, authorizing the award of contract, authorizing bid of contract B-A33, second year option by and between the County of Camden Department of Building Operation and Tech Elevator Inc. for maintenance and repair services for elevators, escalators, and dumb waiters for Camden County and the various outside agencies under the Camden County Cooperative Pricing Agreement in the amount of $310,750, funding contingent upon passage of the 2023 temporary and permanent budgets. 20, resolution authorizing a month-to-month lease agreement by and between the County of Camden and court-appointed special advocates of Camden County Incorporated for office space and City Hall pending re-procurement. 21, resolution authorizing a lease agreement by and between the County of Camden Department of Buildings and Operations and Market Street Properties LLC for lease of office space for the Board of Social Services satellite offices in the amount of $306,000 for a five-year term, funding continued upon passage of the 2023, 2024, 2025, 2026, and 2027 temporary and permanent budgets, and rescinding resolution number 23 approved adopted September 15th, 2022. And 22 is personal actions for Commissioner Kane.
Thank you. Commissioner Dyer, could you go back to resolution 17?
17.
Just want to be clear on what that resolution, what you stated.
Read the whole thing again.
Sure. Yes.
Resolution number 17, authorizing the award of contract bid.
No, it's a rejection. We're rejecting the bid.
Oh.
It was substantially over budget.
Okay.
Resolution 17 rejects a bid, rejects all bids, right?
Okay.
For the Camden County Library library renovations. All bids have been rejected.
Okay.
It was over budget. Thank you.
All right.
Mr. Nash, do you want me to read yours, or are you able to do so?
I would. I would appreciate that, Director.
Okay.
Thank you.
23, inserts Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the Camden County Bench Donation Program in the name of Harold Gazelle in the amount of $1,500. 24, inserts Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the Camden County Bench Program in the name of Marion Butler Pearson in the amount of $1,500. 25, inserts Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the Camden County Bench Donation Program in the name of Noah Samuel Siegel in the amount of $1,500. 26, authorizes award of contract pursuant to bid by and between the County of Camden and Ben Schaefer Recreation, Inc. for the purchase and installation of bleacher systems at the Camden Athletic Complex under the Bergen County Cooperative Purchasing Alliance System in the amount of $41,500. 27, authorizes a lease agreement by between the County of Camden and the Camden County Municipal Utilities Authority for access and use of Gateway Park to provide certain park improvements. 28, authorizes a memorandum of understanding by and between the County of Camden and the Borough of Haddonfield relative to increased access along Cooper Road in the Borough of Haddonfield. 29, authorizes a reimbursement agreement by and between the County of Camden and Rutgers, the State University of New Jersey, to provide support for the Rutgers Cooperative Extension for fiscal year 2022 in the amount of $63,396. 30, ratifies the submission of a grant application by the County of Camden to the State of New Jersey for the 2023 Parks and Trails Grant in the amount of $10 million. 31, amends resolution number 44, adopted July 1, 2022, authorizing the approval of recommendations of the Open Space Preservation Trust Advisory Trust Fund Advisory Committee relative to Round 22 Recreation Facility Enhancement Projects to correct the recipient's name. And 32 are Commissioner Nash's personnel actions. Commissioner Betteridge.
Thank you, Director. Number 33 is resolution 159 funds into the budget for the 2023 Public Health Priority Services Funding Grant in the amount of $333,276. Number 34, resolution inserting Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the 2022-2023 Local Core Capacity for Public Health Emergency Preparedness Grant in the amount of $721,483. Number 35 is a resolution inserting Chapter 159 funds into the budget for 2022 New Jersey State Farmers Market Nutrition Program in the amount of $2,000. Number 36, resolution inserting Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the 2022 Comprehensive Substance Abuse Grant in the amount of $1,584,681. Number 37, resolution inserting Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the Child Care Resource and Referral Services Grant in the amount of $2,780. Number 38, resolution inserting Chapter 159 funds into the budget for Child Care Resource and Referral Services Grant in the amount of $105. Number 39 was pulled. Number 40 is a resolution authorizing agreements pursuant to solicitation of quotations by and between the County of Camden, Department of Health and Human Services on behalf of the Local Advisory Committee on Alcohol and Drug Abuse and the Hendricks House for the provision of halfway house substance abuse treatment services in the amount of $78,000. Funding contingent upon passage of Chapter 159 resolution. 41, resolution authorizing an award of contract pursuant to the solicitation of quotations by and between the County of Camden, Department of Health and Human Services, and Maryville Incorporated for the provision of certified peer recovery specialists in the amount of $45,500, CAF number 990232832. Number 42 is a resolution authorizing an award of contract pursuant to the competitive contracting request for proposal number 22-50 by and between the County of Camden, Department of Health and Human Services, Division of Senior and Disabled Services, and various vendors for the provision of various senior citizen social service programs in the amount of $148,192, funding contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budgets. Number 43 is a resolution authorizing agreements pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden, Department of Health and Human Services, and various local advisory committee on alcohol and drug abuse recommended agencies for provision of substance use disorder services, Operation SAL, in the amount of $449,092. Funding is contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budget. Number 44 is a resolution authorizing agreements pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposal by and between the County of Camden, Department of Health and Human Services, and various local advisory committee on alcohol and drug abuse recommended agencies for provision of professional substance use disorder services in the amount of $1,155,458. Funding contingent upon the passage of Chapter 159 resolution. 45 is a resolution authorizing an agreement pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposal by and between the County of Camden, Department of Health and Human Services, and Oaks Integrated Care Incorporated for the provision of mental health services in the amount of $273,000, funding contingent upon passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budget. Number 46 is a resolution authorizing an agreement pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden, Department of Health and Human Services, and Genesis Counseling Center, Incorporated, for the provision of professional substance abuse services for the Project SAVE program in the amount of $316,870. Funding is contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary or permanent budget. Number 47, resolution authorizing agreements pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden Department of Health and Human Services and Planned Parenthood of Northern, Central, and Southern New Jersey Incorporated for the provision of professional medical health services in the amount of $78,750. Funding contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary or permanent budget. Number 48, resolution authorizing agreements pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposal by and between the County of Camden, Department of Health and Human Services, and various approved nonprofit agencies for the provision of social services for the homeless program, temporary aid to needy families, and intensive care management services in the amount of $889,936 and various CAF numbers. Number 49 is a resolution authorizing an award of contract pursuant to state contract number 19-fleet-00566 by and between the County of Camden Department of Health and Human Services and W.W. Granger Incorporated for purchase of storage containers and shelving units in the amount of $29,999. Resolution number 50. Authorizes an agreement by and between the County of Camden Department of Health and Human Services and Community Planning and Advocacy Council for the provision of management services for various human services programs in the amount of $140,000, funding contingent upon passage of the 2023 temporary and/or permanent budgets. Number 51 is a resolution amending resolution number 30 adopted November 10, 2022. Authorizing a shared services agreement by and between the County of Camden Department of Health and Human Services, Office of Mental Health and Addiction, and the Camden County College for the provision of intoxicated driver resource services to correct a typographical error. Number 52 is a resolution authorizing an agreement by and between the County of Camden Department of Health and Human Services and Cooper Healthcare System Incorporated for the provision of professional medical health services in the total amount of $54,600, funding contingent upon the passage of 2023 temporary and/or permanent budget. Number 53 is a resolution ratifying an award of contract emergency purchase by and between the County of Camden Department of Health and Human Services and Ace Motor Sales Incorporated for the purchase of one Ford F-450 in the amount of $67,999.50, purchase order number 225850. Number 54, resolution authorizing the appointment of members to the Camden County Board of Social Services. Number 55 is a resolution authorizing the appointment of a member to the Mental Health Board. Number 56 is the resolution approving personnel actions requested by or on behalf of myself.
Thank you, Commissioner Young.
Thank you, Director. Hold on, guys, gonna be a while. 57, resolution inserting chapter 159 funds into the budget from the State of New Jersey Department of Human Services, Division of Family Development and TANF Transportation Services in the amount of $511,616. 58 is inserting chapter 159 funds into the budget for the fiscal year 2021 State Body Armor Replacement Fund Grant for the Department of Corrections in the amount of $10,014.14. 59 is authorizing cancellation, a stale check written for the Camden County Correctional Facility and Juvenile Detention Center bank accounts. 60 is authorizing award of contract pursuant to the solicitation of quotations by and between the County of Camden and Department of Corrections and Community Cares for the provisional transitional housing for homeless individuals released from the Department of Corrections in amount of $37,800. 61 is authorizing award of contract pursuant to the competitive contracting request for proposal by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and Keith Commensary Network LLC for inmate commissary services for the Camden County Correctional Facility and Juvenile Detention Facility. 62, authorizing An agreement pursuant to competitive contract and request for proposal by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and Juvenile and Division of Juvenile Justice and CFG Health Systems Incorporated for a single health authority to provide comprehensive medical, mental health, substance, and dental health care and services for inmates of the Camden County Correctional Facilities in the amount of $13,988,990.74. Funding contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budgets. 63 is authorized an agreement pursuant to a competitive contract request for proposal, third year option by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and Aramark Correctional Services LLC for food services for the Camden County Juvenile Detention Facility and the amount of $5.92 per meal funding contingent upon passage of the 2023 and or permanent budget.
That could be an expensive meal there, huh?
Yeah. It's actually down.
Yeah, good. 64, authorizing agreement pursuant to publicly advertised request for proposal by between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and Restorative Center for Training and Restorative and Transformative Justice for Youth and Communities Pilot Program Services in the amount of $120,000, funding contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budgets. 65 is authorizing agreement pursuant to publicly advertised request for proposal by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections, Division of Juvenile Justice, and various vendors for the provisions of positive youth development services and detention alternative innovative services in the amount of $934,717, funding contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budgets. 66 is authorizing a month-to-month agreement pursuant to competitive contract and request for proposal by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and Juvenile Division and the Center for Family Services for Detention Alternative Shelter Services pending reprocurement of these services. 67 is authorizing an award of contract by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and SHI International Corp for expansion of security systems in the Juvenile Detention Center facility and Yes Shelter facility under the New Jersey Cooperative Pricing Allowance System in the total amount of $55,361.64. 68 is authoring an award of contract by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and SHI International Court for the renewal license and certification of facilities CCTV network under the New Jersey Cooperative Pricing Allowance System in the amount of $19,764.11. 69 is authorizing an award of contract. This is a state contract, A84242, by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and BI Correctional Services Incorporated for inmate electronic monitoring services and equipment in the amount of $163,348.45, funded contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budgets. 70 is authorizing agreement and by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and Liam Connect LLC relative to a pilot program to test and evaluate the automated letter and photo system. Can we go back to that real quick? Just to kind of give everybody a little, this is a really unique systems, right? So we're trying to find ways of trying to keep narcotics and things out of the jail, right? And we've noticed that they come through the mail sometimes, and we can't get it, where they get really, really creative now. It's not just a baggie in the envelope anymore. The paper itself sometimes can be the drug. You dilute it and it becomes the drug. So this system here actually will take the letter and put it into electronic form and then give it to the inmate or resident in the jail. So this way here, they're not receiving that. So it's just a way for us to prevent more narcotics from coming into our jail. So I just wanted to kind of mention that a little bit. 71. Resolution ratifying a submission of grant application by and between the County of Camden Department of Corrections and the New Jersey Department of Community Affairs Division of Local Government Services for Courthouse Regional Corrections Center and Initiative 2023 grant in the amount of $15 million. 72 is authorizing appointment of a member to the Camden County Workforce Development Board. 73 is authorizing award a contract pursuant to solicitations of quotations by and between the County of Camden and unnamed vehicle technologies for the purchase of a drone in the amount of $32,078.01. 74 is ratifying award of contract, state contract by and between the County of Camden Department of Public Safety and Modern Group LTD for test equipment for emergency backup generators in the amount of $22,127.50. 75 is authorizing award of contract, state contract by and between the County of Camden Department of Public Safety and Municipal Energy Services Incorporated for the purchase of a hazmat PPE clothing in the amount of $18,275. 76 is authorizing award of contract by and between the County of Camden Department of Public Safeties and Intrudo Life and Safety Solutions for the maintenance contract for the Viper 911 telephone system in amount of $151,628.06. 77 is authorizing a memorandum of understanding by and between the County of Camden Department of Public Safety and the Office of Emergency Management for the State of New Jersey Office of Emergency Management relative to application for grants under the Federal Emergency Management Agency Public Assistance and or Hazardous Mitigation Programs for presidential declared major disasters. 78 is authorizing memorandum of understanding by and between the County of Camden and public and the Department of Public Safety and Office of Emergency Management and the State of New Jersey State Emergency Response Commission relative to the designation of Camden Counties as an emergency planning district. 79, resolution ratifying a submission of grant applications by the County of Camden Department of Public Safety to the State of New Jersey for the Next Generation 911 Fiscal 2023 grant in the amount of $700,000. Can you hold this for a minute there, please, Stu? This is another one here. This is something that we've been working on for years and years and
well,
years.
Well, you took the lead on this, yeah. Commissioner, so you should take all the credit in the world for this.
This is where they were taking your 911 money, a fee out of your pocket every bill cycle to generate money for the state. The state never gave us the money back. Billions of dollars were siphoned from this fund. And I said it right, siphoned. It wasn't given.
Absolutely right.
So we at NJAC, we really started to fight this a lot. We got $10 million put back into the budget for this fund. And this $700,000 is coming back to Camden County as a result of that effort. So
you really did a great job.
Yeah, thank
Just
you.
Just a little history. I remember being on a Governor McGreevy used to do these like monthly conference calls with counties. I don't know if you remember that, Ross, but I remember he talked about this new tax on cell phone bills for New Jersey residents mm-hmm. and how all this money was going to flow back to counties and municipalities for their 911 systems. That was Governor McGreevy. How many years ago was that? We've not received a dime. This will be the first money we receive.
Yeah. So it's really big. And it's for us. I mean, listen, for everybody who don't know, answering phone calls down to 911 is more than that, right? You have to take upgrades. If you listen to the reports, there's millions of dollars in upgrades that we spend every year on it. And this money will help us offset some of that call. So
great job.
Thank you. Number 80, resolution ratifying the submission of grant application by the County of Camden Department of Health and Human Services and Public Safety to the New Jersey Department of Environmental Protection for the 2022-23 County Environmental Health Act grant in the amount of $456,258. 81 is authorizing award a contract pursuant to NJSA 40A:11-5.1DD by and between the County of Camden Department of Public Safety and Securus Technologies Incorporated for the maintenance and support services for the CAD systems and servers in the amount of $275,876. 82 is authorizing an appointment of a Camden County Assistant Fire Marshal. 83 is authorizing public safety employees for membership to the New Jersey State Police Office of Emergency Management Urban Search and Rescue Unit, New Jersey Task Force 1. 84 is authorizing shared service agreement binding between the County of Camden One Stop and the New Jersey Transportation Authority for the provision of comprehensive transportation systems for the active TANF workforce participation in accordance to the Camden County Community Transportation Plan in the amount of $456,800, funding contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budgets. 85 is authorizing an agreement by and between the County of Camden and the One Stop and the National Center for Advocacy for Recovery for Behavioral Health to provide reimbursement to the county for the cost of police services in the amount of $5,046.72. 86 is authorizing approval execution by the County of Camden One Stop of the transit. The resolution authorizing approval and execution by the County of Camden and the One Stop of the transportation contract with the New Jersey Department of Human Services Division of Family Development in the amount of $511,616, funding contingent upon the passage of the Chapter 159 resolution. 87 is authorizing award of a contract lease pursuant to the competitive contracting request for proposal, third year option bind between the County of Camden and the Office of Sustainability and Shared Services and Homeward Bound Pet Adoption Center for the operation and maintenance of the Camden County Animal Shelter in an amount of $393,713, funding contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and or permanent budgets. 88 is authorizing award of contract buying between the County of Camden and the Office of Sustainability and Shared Services and Decker's Hardscape and Landscaping Incorporated for the purchase and installation of two new greenhouses in the amount of $150,000. We're continuing to go green here in Camden County. 89 are my personnel actions on my behalf.
Thank you. Deputy Director McDonald.
Thank you, Director. 90 is a resolution authorizing budgetary transfers in the 2022 current fund budget. 91 is a resolution authorizing the cancellation of checks in various Camden County checking accounts. 92 is a resolution authorizing the cancellation of certain reserve and receivable balances for grant accounts. 93 is a resolution authorizing the cancellation of appropriations in the 2022 current budget. 94 is a resolution authorizing pay increases for unclassified and classified management employees. 95 is a resolution authorizing an agreement pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden and Bowman and Company LLP for the 2022 annual financial and compliance audits for the County of Camden and county agencies and authorities in the amount of $355,000. 96 is a resolution authorizing an agreement pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden Division of Insurance and Wellness Coaches USA for the provision of wellness program services for Camden County employees in the amount of $126,624, funding contingent upon the passage of the 2022 temporary and or permanent budgets. 97 is a resolution memorializing the commitment of matching funds for the Camden County College Securing Our Children's Future Bond Act grant application in the amount of $1,333,333. 98 is a resolution amending resolution number 73, adopted October 20th, 2022, establishing program and funding categories relating to Camden County's allocation of American Rescue Plan funds. 99 is a resolution authorizing an award of contract pursuant to NJSA 40A by and between the County of Camden Board of Elections and Election Systems and Software LLC for the purchase of voting machines in the amount of $4,241,178. Resolution 100 authorizes an award of contract pursuant to NJSA 40A by and between the County of Camden Board of Elections and Inclusion Solutions LLC for the purchase of voter privacy booths in the amount of $868,731.70. 101 is a resolution authorizing an award of contract pursuant to NJSA 40A by and between the County of Camden Board of Elections and 10X Software Solutions for the purchase of ballot printers and electronic poll book label printers in the amount of $1,717,750. 102 is a resolution authorizing an award of contract pursuant to solicitation of quotations by and between the County of Camden, Department of Events and Community Outreach, and the Collingswood Foundation for the Arts for services related to the 2023 Martin Luther King Freedom Medal Ceremony in the amount of $15,460, funding contingent upon passage of the 2023 temporary and/or permanent budgets. 103 is a resolution authorizing a shared services agreement by and between the County of Camden Department of Events and Community Outreach and Camden County College for program services for seniors and special needs residents in the amount of $110,000 plus costs and expenses, funding contingent upon the passage of the 2023 temporary and/or permanent budgets. 104 is a resolution authorizing an award of contract BA54-2022 by and between the County of Camden Department of Administration Division of Cooper River Venues and EZ Docs Unlimited LLC for dock extension in the amount of $67,500. Whoops. 105 is a resolution authorizing an award of contract pursuant to state contract number 19-Fleet-00566 by and between the County of Camden, Department of Administration, Division of Cooper River Venues, and W.W. Granger, Inc. for the purchase of golf supplies in the amount of $25,787. And 106 is a resolution approving personnel actions requested by or on behalf of myself.
Thank you, Deputy Director. 107 inserts Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the Camden County Prosecutor's Office Community Outreach and Engagement Unit 2022 Thanksgiving Food Drive in the amount of $1,000. 108 inserts Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the fiscal year 2022 Overdose Data to Action Operation Helping Hand Grant Program in the amount of $50,000. 109 inserts Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the state fiscal year 2022 Governor Phil Murphy Operation Helping Hand Program in the amount of $41,269.83. 110 inserts Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the 2022 Home Program in the amount of $83,080. 111 inserts Chapter 159 funds into the budget for the 2021 Home Program in the amount of $243,646. 112 authorizes award of contract under state contract by and between the County of Camden and West Publishing Corporation for software licenses in the amount of $31,401.12, funding contingent upon passage of the 2023 and 2024 temporary and/or permanent budgets. 113 authorizes award of contract under state contract by and between the County of Camden and Insight Public Sector, Inc. for InfoShare maintenance in the amount of $125,000, funding contingent upon passage of the 2023 temporary and permanent budgets. 114 authorizes award of contract under state contract by and between the County of Camden and Xerox Corporation for print management services in the amount of $40,000, funding contingent upon passage of the 2023 temporary and/or permanent budgets. 115 ratifies the submission of a grant application by the County of Camden to Hassan Reddick for the 2022 Thanksgiving Food Drive in the amount of $1,000. 116, amends resolution number 83, adopted July 21, 2022, authorizing the submission of a grant application by the County of Camden to the State of New Jersey Department of Law and Public Safety, Office of the Attorney General, for the state fiscal year 2022 Governor Phil Murphy budget Operation Helping Hand grant to increase the amount by $41,269.83 for a total grant request of $165,079.33. 117 authorizes award of contract under NJSA 40A:11-6.1 binding between the County of Camden and Safety Matters, Inc. for the provision of eSafetyOnline.com compliance training for employees in the amount of $37,876. Funding is contingent upon passage of the 2023 temporary and/or permanent budgets. 118 authorizes award of contract by and between the County of Camden and Municipal Emergency Services, Inc. for the purchase of uniforms on an as-needed basis and rescinding resolution number 80, adopted November 10, 2022. 119 authorizes an award of contract under state contract by and between the County of Camden and Metropolitan Contract Carpets for new flooring in the amount of $24,170. 120 amends resolution number 89, adopted August 19th, 2021, authorizing award of contracts pursuant to a competitive contracting request for proposals, number 21-13, by and between the County of Camden and various vendors for the provision of 2021 federal home funds to create affordable housing for the County of Camden, to rescind the award to Fortitude Supportive Urban Renewal. 121 is an authorizes award of contracts pursuant to a competitive contracting request for proposals number 22-29 by and between the County of Camden and various vendors for the provision of 2022 federal home funds to create affordable housing for the County of Camden in the amount of $2,613,227, funding available in the amount of $500,000, balance of funding contingent upon passage of reallocation resolutions. 122 authorizes award of contract under state contract by and between the County of Camden and WW Granger, Inc. for the purchase of care packets for the homeless in the amount of $30,000. 123 ratifies a shared service agreement by and between the County of Camden and the City of Camden for the provision of Code Blue warming shelters in the amount of $155,000. 124 amends resolution number 62, adopted April 18th, 2019, authorizing the submission of a grant application by the County of Camden to the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development for the fiscal year 2019 Consolidated Strategy and Action Plan Program to reallocate funding. 125 amends resolution number 66, adopted June 18th, 2020, authorizing the submission of a grant application by the County of Camden to the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development for the fiscal year 2020 Consolidated Strategy and Action Plan Program to reallocate funding. 126 amends resolution number 86, adopted June 17th, 2021, ratifying the submission of a grant application by the County of Camden to the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development for the fiscal year 2021 Consolidated Strategy and Action Plan to reallocate funding. Number 127 amends resolution number 91, adopted June 16th, 2022, authorizing the submission of a grant application by the County of Camden to the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development for fiscal year 2022, Consolidated Strategy and Action Plan to reallocate funding. 128 authorizes an agreement pursuant to a publicly advertised request for proposals by and between the County of Camden and Madden and Madden, PA, with the provision of affirmative action officer slash equal employment officer services for the County of Camden, various Camden County agencies and authorities, and the City of Camden on an as-needed basis. Resolution 129 regards a ban on carrying concealed weapons on county property. 130 authorizes an award of contract pursuant to solicitation of quotations by and between the County of Camden, Belmar Truck Repair Company, Inc. for automotive repairs in the amount of $5,148.01. Resolution 131 authorizes the award of a contract pursuant to solicitation of quotations by and between the County of Camden and Insight Public Sector, Inc. for the purchase of one Apple MacBook Pro in the amount of $1,934.41. 132 ratifies an award of contract pursuant to solicitation of quotations by and between the County of Camden and Dynamic Imaging Systems, Inc. for maintenance of the PictureLink imaging system in the amount of $36,325. 133 authorizes an agreement pursuant to a competitive contracting request for proposals number 1842, third one-year option by and between the County of Camden and Extra Duty Solutions for secondary employment management information system services. 134 rejects bid A49/2022 for the purchase of an audiovisual management system, as the one bid received was non-compliant with the bid specifications. Resolution 135 authorizes award of contract bid A55/2022 by and between the County of Camden and B&H Photo for the purchase of computer monitors in the amount of $49,050. Number 136 authorizes award of contract by and between the County of Camden and SHI International Corp. for the purchase of various hardware for the Eye in the Sky under the New Jersey Cooperative Purchasing Alliance System ID number CK04 in the amount of $386,049.60. 137 ratifies award of contract under state contract by and between the County of Camden and Lawmen Supply Company of New Jersey, Inc. for the purchase of ammunition in the amount of $24,791.24. Number 138 authorizes the award of contract under state contract by and between the County of Camden and Dell Marketing LP for software licenses in the amount of $121,330.50. 139 ratifies an award of contract under state contract by and between the County of Camden and Lawmen Supply Company of New Jersey, Inc. for the purchase of ballistic vests in the amount of $41,918.82. Number 140 ratifies a lease agreement by and between the County of Camden and Relden Enterprises, LLC for the lease of a single story facility located in the Mount Ephraim Shopping Center, City of Camden, in the amount of $30. Number 141 authorizes award of contract by and between County of Camden and Mall Chevrolet for automotive repairs in the amount of $501.98. 142 are my personnel actions. 143 are personnel actions requested by or on behalf of constitutional or statutory row officers. I now open the meeting to the public for discussion of resolutions.
Director, we have a few comments. The first is on the screen. Can you read that?
I'm sorry, can you say that again?
We have a comment, from the member of the public. It's thank you, commissioners, for reading the resolutions. It's important to hear what you're voting on. Nice improvement from the blanket yay votes that was your past protocol to pass all resolutions.
We are following the same protocol we've always used. We haven't changed since I've been since I've been a member of this board.
Not one thing has changed.
And Director, we have a second comment from Patrick McDade. Will a recording of the live stream be posted? My internet cut out in the middle and some talk was missed.
Do we post a live recording? Do we post a recording of this meeting on our website?
Oh, we did.
No. Can we look into that? Or?
I think we do. To look into that.
We'll get back to you on that, Pat McDade.
And Director Kate Delaney is asked to speak.
Kate Delaney.
Kate, you may unmute.
Great. Thank you, commissioners. I realize that this is not the public comment that's open to all, but I did want to flag, since you asked if anyone wanted to be heard on the resolutions, that the resolutions are not publicly available before the meeting. So to ask if people want to be heard on the resolutions is, you know, not the most productive of questions. I would appreciate if they were available online. Commissioner Capelli, no, your meetings are not posted online. I get them via OPA requests, but not all citizens necessarily know how to do that. But again, if you're going to have a portion of public comment that's devoted to questions about the resolutions, it would be great if residents could get access to those resolutions. It is a really long agenda, but I think that people could flip through and look at the resolutions that are of interest to them. And I would also flag that, you know, you've been reading to your constituents for over almost an hour. I do appreciate Commissioner Young taking a few minutes to talk about one of the items that he was voting on. This is your caucus session. It would be great if I left the caucus session feeling like I knew more about what you're about as my elected representatives, how you make your decisions, to hear some deliberative process. You'll be having the same exact meeting on Thursday. So again, the resolutions publicly available would be wonderful so people could participate. And again, you know, I assume people can read the agenda for themselves, but I think people would like to hear the deliberations made by their elected officials.
Right. So the detailed explanation or heading of each resolution is posted by no later than Monday before the meeting on our website, where you can also click onto our website and ask any questions you want regarding the resolutions that we'll be considering in our meeting today. So a detailed heading is available. Once the resolutions are ratified, then they are made available in their full length. But you can certainly ask any questions you want regarding the resolutions, not just at this meeting, but prior to this meeting on our website.
Right. I appreciate that. And again, it would be great, though, before you're voting on these resolutions, if citizens could see the actual resolution. I go to a lot of government meetings, and I know that's a pretty standard practice.
Thank you.
I see no questions at this time, Director.
Is there a motion to close the public portion? Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Public portion is closed. Whereas Section 8 of the Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231, PL 1975, permits the exclusion of the public from a meeting in certain circumstances. And whereas this public body is of the opinion that circumstances presently exist, now therefore be resolved by the Board of Commissioners of the County of Camden, State of New Jersey, as follows. One, the public shall be excluded from discussion of the hearing after specified subject matter. Two, the general nature of the subject matter to be discussed is personnel. Three, it is anticipated at this time that the above subject matter will be made public when members of the Camden County Board of Commissioners have made final determination before this resolution shall take effect immediately. Are we seeing anything? I'm sorry. Is there anything else from the public?
We did receive a comment. I think people want to make general comments from Kate Delaney. Is there a general public comment period happening before closed session?
No, this will be, we're going into closed session, and then anything we act on in closed session that needs, as I was about to say, it is pending at this time, the above subject matter will be made public when members of the Camden County Board of Commissioners have made final determination. Is there a motion to adopt the closed session resolution?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor? Opposed? Thank you. We're going to closed session. Now, returning to open, there is one matter to report on, or one resolution to read as a result of closed session, a resolution setting the annual salary for the sheriff of Camden County. And with that, I will take a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Meeting's adjourned. Thank you, everybody.